So, do acids produce ions only in aqueous solution or not? Then what is our aim to check whether acids produce ions only in aqueous solution or not? That you have to check. We need test tube, we need dry blue litmus paper, dry blue litmus paper and with litmus paper, and next one is wet blue litmus paper, wet blue litmus paper, and also we need dropper, we need dropper to place to drop acids. So what you have to do, procedure, what precautions while you are dropping the, while you are place pouring the acid, we had used a dropper by wearing the gloves. That's the precautions. Now we have to take one test tube, we have to take one test tube. In this test tube, we have to place sodium chloride solution. Sodium chloride solution. That means solid sodium chloride we have to take. Solid sodium chloride in a clean and dry test tube. In a clean and dry test tube. And we have to add now sulfuric acid. So it is a combination of sulfuric acid plus sodium chloride. Sodium chloride. So sodium chloride is a solid, sodium chloride is a solid, and this sulfuric acid is a aqueous solution. It is a liquid or aqueous solution. Then it's a liquid. Then we will get this split in split. We will get sodium sulfate plus hydrogen chloride gas. Will liberate. Hydrogen chloride gas will liberate. We have to balance 2 NaCl and 2 HCl. Then it is balanced. Now we will get the gas will be released from the open end of the test tube. Gas will be released from the open end of the this test tube. If the gas is releasing, then we have to place blue litmus paper. Blue litmus paper we have to place. When you place blue litmus paper, then whether it will turn into blue or not, that we have to check. Blue litmus paper we have to place. When you place blue litmus paper, this blue litmus paper, this is a dry blue litmus paper. First we will place dry blue litmus paper. Dry blue litmus paper. When you place dry blue litmus paper, it won't turn into red. Why? This HCl gas, whatever the HCl gas, in absence of water, it is not acting as, it is not producing any ions. That means it won't split into H plus and Cl minus. When it won't give ions, it won't act as a acid. Then it won't turn blue litmus paper to red. It won't turn blue litmus paper to red. So same what you called experiment once again you have to do with the same sulfuric acid and sodium chloride. And again in this case also, we will get certain amount, certain gas will be released, same HCl gas. Now you place wet blue litmus paper you have to place. If you place wet litmus paper, now the wet litmus paper will turn into blue, red. This blue litmus paper will turn into red. Now why it turns into red? Because this litmus paper is a wet. So whenever hydrogen chloride gas, when presence of water, it will become a hydrochloric acid. That hydrochloric acid will turn blue litmus paper to red. That means these acids will produce ions only in aqueous solution. If there is absence of water molecule in dry litmus paper, it not turn into red. Whereas wet litmus paper turns into red. It means in presence of water only, It is a hydrogen chloride is acid, is a acid. It shows acidic nature. In absence of water, it's not showing any acidic nature and it is not producing any ions. So because of water present here, it produces ions and become a hydrochloric acid. That hydrochloric acid will turn blue litmus paper to red. In that, so from this we can tell that acids will produce ions. Acids can produce ions only in aqueous solutions, not in all solutions. Now here a little bit precaution we have to take care. If the condition is humid condition, if the weather is humid weather, what is the meaning of humid weather? In air, if we have a water vapor, then with that water vapor, is it even dry blue litmus paper also become wet litmus paper, then that will also, in both the cases, it will turn into red. Then we will think that if it is only dry blue litmus paper, if we take also, it is a, the hydrogen chloride is turning into red, we will think. So the, what you have to do, we have to use a guard tube. You have to use guard tube. Guard tube, which is coated with calcium chloride, calcium anhydrous calcium chloride, which is coated inside with anhydrous calcium chloride. When this anhydrous calcium chloride will absorb water present in air, and humid air will become dry air. Humid air will become dry air. As a result, what you call, we can able to do this experiment without experimental error. So all, even bases also will dissolve. Even bases also dissolve in water and gives rise to ions, OH minus ions, like a sodium hydroxide will split into Na plus OH minus ion. Potassium hydroxide will split into K plus OH minus ion. Magnesium hydroxide will split into magnesium Mg plus 2 and OH minus ion. So like that, all bases which are soluble in water, the bases which are soluble in water will come under what we call alkalis. So the bases which are soluble in water, they are known as bases soluble in water. Bases soluble in water are known as alkalis. What is it? Alkalis. In a periodic table, for 1A group elements and 2A group elements are metals, all that metals are alkalis. What is it? Alkalis. And even beryllium hydroxide is slightly soluble in water. But the remaining all 1A group and 2A group elements are highly soluble in water, which are known as alkalis. What is it? Alkalis. So, like this, we can able to tell that only what you call acids produce H plus ions. H plus ions, this is known as a guard tube, which is also known as dry tube. Guard tube, which is also known as dry tube. Dry tube, the dry tube is coated with calcium chloride, which will absorb what they call humid water vapor from air. Thank you.